Hello everyone. Hope you are all in the best of spirits, health and disposition. Welcome to the new video of Quest of Truth. After my recent video, I had had many requests for explaining homeopathic philosophy, and particularly Richard Hughes' homeopathic philosophy from the book The Principles and Practice of Homeopathy. Also, there had been a special request from a lot of them to, try explaining the concepts more precisely in the local languages or in Hindi, to be particular. So I would try to explain it in English as well as in Hindi to some extent, so that others might also relate to it for those who cannot understand English that much. Okay, so today we are going to talk about Richard Hughes' philosophy. Before we begin with today's session, let me thank Central Council of Homeopathy, CCH, for including Richard Hughes' philosophy into our syllabus. Because personally, I'm of the opinion that as we see, most of the philosophers of homeopathic philosophy they have a very dogmatic and theoretical idea of homeopathy, as opposed to the more scientific and open-minded attitude of the basic, Hahnemannian perspective. So I see Richard Hughes has this, it is not completely theoretical. The essential character of Hughesian homeopathy was that it lay at the scientific end of the homeopathic spectrum of opinion. So to speak, for instance, the principle of similia lied at the center stage for his, practice. But still, it was in a relaxed and more non-dogmatic way. He said that the principle of similia was like a skeleton key to open a therapeutic lock. Okay, it lends you the right answer most of the times, but not invariably, not all the time, and there are chances wherein other keys may also fit in. Okay, so it was not like a complete doctrine or law. He took it more relaxedly as a method of method rather than a system. In that sense, he realized the shortcomings of homeopathy, and he also understood the fancies and fallacies that were getting incorporated into the then prevalent homeopathic system, and produced a lot of critical discussions, proof readings, and there was plenty of critical discussions in his contributions. Apart from that, there was many important concepts and ideas that he put forward. For instance, he put a lot of emphasis on the objective pathological symptoms as well, not completely overlooking the subjective symptoms. His encyclopedia of drug pathogenesis, in his encyclopedia of drug pathogenesis, he gives the provings in a narrative form so that the physician understands it more aptly. He also emphasized on taking the time sequence of appearance of symptoms in the totality of symptoms so that you get at the correct indicated remedy. So even in the Materia Medica Pura, in the Hahnemann's Materia Medica Pura, while translating it, he had been of immeasurable help to Dr. R. E. Dudgeon. And he has got many academic contributions. So now we have to jump into the actual topic. So let's keep this aside for later on. अच्छा तो रिचर्ड ह्यूज़ के हिसाब से लॉ ऑफ सिमिलर्स ये एक क्या कहते हैं बेसिक मेथड था क्योर करने का. ठीक है, तो ये जो मेथड है इससे वो ही वाज लाइक आपको आंसर मिल सकता है बट नॉट एवरी टाइम, मतलब इनवेरिएबली ये यूज़ करेंगे तो पक्का तुमको आंसर आएगा ही, ऐसा कभी नहीं कहा उन्होंने. और उनका ऐसा था कि इट इज़ वर्थ ट्राइंग, इट इज़ नॉट द ओनली की वर्थ ट्राइंग, राइट. For example, he was of the opinion के अभी angina है patient को तो you can opt for contraria contrarius. For example, जहाँ पे अपना ससेप्टेबिलिटी फुली फंक्शनल है, जहाँ पे यू नो द पावर ऑफ रिएक्शन ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म ये इंटैक्ट है, तब तक आप उनसे क्या कहते हैं, यू कैन यूज़ होम्योपैथिक मेडिसिन और होम्योपैथिक रेमेडी टू यू नो गेट बैक द व्हाट्स इट हेल्थ, टू रिस्टोर द सिक टू हेल्थ. लेकिन जहाँ ससेप्टेबिलिटी काम ही नहीं कर रही है, जहाँ पे रिएक्शनरी पावर ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म कम्प्लीटली निल है, तो कितना भी होम्योपैथी दो वो इंसान का रिएक्शन आने नहीं वाला. तो इन दो सिचुएशंस रिचर्ड ह्यूज के हिसाब से भी बोलो और मास्टर हैनमन के हिसाब से भी बोलो, वी आर सपोज टू यू नो लैंड टू क्या कहते हैं एलोपैथिक सिस्टम ऑफ मेडिसिन. ऑल्सो यस, जहाँ पे सर्जरी चाहिए वहाँ पे सर्जरी चाहिए. तो ये सब कैसे शॉर्टकमिंग्स है होम्योपैथी के. विदाउट फर्दर अडू, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रैक्टिस ऑफ होम्योपैथी बाय डॉक्टर रिचर्ड ह्यूज. दिस लेक्चर टॉक्स अबाउट होम्योपैथी, इट्स नेचर एंड ओरिजिन. ओके, फॉर कन्वीनियंस लेट्स वी कैन सब डिवाइड द लेक्चर इन टू फॉलोइंग 9 पॉइंट्स. एम, फर्स्ट इज एम, basic definition of homeopathy, the problem, the solution, the birth of homeopathy, then the creation of fragmenta de viribus medicamentorum positivus, then single remedy and reduced doses, conclusions, and notes to the lecture 1. The notes to the lecture 1 is again divided into 2 parts. Note 1. Okay, so let me be very clear. We are going to go very slowly, slowly. Okay. My aim is not to complete. Okay. My aim is not to complete this lecture, a single lecture in one go. Never. I can never do that. We are going to actually dissect each and every part and try to understand what pearls of wisdom can be collect from each and every paragraph, each and every line, if we can, and understand and try to inculcate into our lives. Okay, so this is a learning process, slow, steady learning process. Okay, so beginning with the first part of the lecture number 1 of Principles and Practice of Homeopathy by Richard Hughes. The first part is, as I told you earlier, the aim. The aim of the first lecture is, what can homeopathy do in various recognized forms of diseases, and in what effect or by what instruments is it going to affect its doing. Okay, to uska matlab homeopathy kya kar sakti hai alag alag diseases mein aur kaise karegi, kya kar sakti hai aur kya kaise karegi. Theek hai, now we have to be very observant. अब देखिए, द फिलोसोफर नोस, ही हैजंट सेड कि इट वुड क्योर डायरेक्टली, राइट ना. उन्होंने बोला कि इट कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग. स्पेक्ट्रम के मतलब एक्सट्रीम्स है, एंड यू कैन गेट द जेस्ट ऑफ द साइंटिफिक टेम्पर ऑफ दिस फिलोसोफर राइट फ्रॉम द एम ऑफ हिज फर्स्ट लेक्चर इटसेल्फ. सी हाउ ब्यूटिफुली ही हैज पुट फॉरवर्ड कि he hasn't said that it cannot do anything, neither does he claim completely ki it is going to give you a 100% cure. He has said there is something that homeopathy can do, there is something that homeopathy can do in various forms of recognized diseases. Har disease form mein jo aapko pata hai, jo under the sun milta hai hum logo ko, har disease mein wo kuch na kuch to karti hai. Theek hai, wo kya karti hai aur wo kaise karti hai, ये चीज़ सीखने मिलेगा हम लोगों को फर्स्ट लेक्चर में, राइट. सेकेंड पार्ट है बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ होम्योपैथी. सो वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट कैन होम्योपैथी डू इन वेरियस रिकॉग्नाइज्ड फॉर्म्स ऑफ डिजीजेस, एंड हाउ एंड विथ व्हाट इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स कैन इज इट गोइंग टू अफेक्ट डूइंग इट इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रैक्टिस ऑफ होम्योपैथी. इन केस यू वॉन्ट टू नो इट, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that you get the recent updates. And please like the video if you like the content and the idea. Please do share with your friends and family and other homeopathic students who would want to know about this mastermind philosopher. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy.